Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Maria and on my channel I like to do videos around everything nursing. I also have a handful of lifestyle content, so make sure you check it out. I am trying to get to 10,000 subscribers, so I'd really appreciate it if you guys subscribe to my channel and also if you gave this video a like. Not only does it help with the growth of my channel, it also tells YouTube that you guys would like to see more videos like this. As always, this video is in partnership with www.nursingpersonalstatement.co.uk, so make sure you check that website out if you haven't done so already. It's such a fantastic resource. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys four nursing school myths. I'm going to be clarifying them because there is truth to every myth. There's a truth to every lie. There is a truth to every myth. So I'm going to, you know, clarify them and, you know, just kind of give you guys tips and advice based off it as well. So the first myth is that all your placements will be at a hospital. I'm sure that a lot of you guys know that when you do sign on to your nursing degree, you spend 50% of your time at theory and 50% of your time at placement. That basically just means 50% of your time will be at your university or doing university work, and the other 50% will be at placement. And one myth is that people think that all of your placements will be at a hospital. No and yes. Yes, in a sense that all your placements will be in some sort of healthcare facility, but no, in a sense that all your placements will be at hospital. You'll have placements at hospitals, you'll have placements at community healthcare facilities, you'll have placements at hospice, at GP practices, at sexual health clinics, at IVF clinics. You'll have your placements at a wide variety of places. Anywhere that you can think of a graduate nurse working, that is where you can have your placement. So if you're thinking, oh my gosh, when I graduate, I want to be a GP nurse, I want to work in A&E, I want to work in a prison service, I want to be, you know, one of those nurses giving out the COVID vaccine, I want to work for the Prime Minister and, you know, work as an airplane nurse or work on a cruise ship, that is literally, okay, maybe not cruise ship and maybe not with the Prime Minister, let's just be real, but your placements will cover a wide variety of healthcare facilities. And I talked about this point in my previous video, but at my university, the first year of nursing was general, regardless of whether you studied adult nursing, mental health nursing, child nursing, or learning disability nursing. So you may even have placements at places that do not directly relate to what it is you chose to study. The second myth is that nursing school wants you to fail. Nursing school doesn't want you to fail. Your professors don't want you to fail. University as a business doesn't want you to fail. Think about it, you're literally paying over 9K a year. The university is profiting. If you took out loans from student finance, they're also profiting from the interest rates that you're gonna pay. Why would they want you to fail? You're paying all of this money so that when you graduate, you can work as an independent practitioner and help people. Why would they want you to fail? Like, it's actually not logical. Like, that doesn't actually make any sense at all. And I think where this myth may have come from is just the differences between, you know, how you're kind of cared for as a GCSE and as a college student in comparison to how you're cared for as a university student. Looking back at my experience, when I failed one of my nursing essays, I actually don't remember getting any emails from anyone. I think maybe I got one email, but I really don't remember people approaching me saying, oh Marie, you failed your essay, we've got to help you, blah, blah, blah. If you know your seminar lead says that for the next seminar, you've got to read 3 chapters of this book and you don't read 3 chapters of this book, best believe they're not going to be chasing you. They're not going to be emailing you all of this other stuff unless it's having a negative impact, you know, on a wide variety and a lot of people on that course. In comparison to GCSE or sixth form or college, where a lot of us has come from, if you even miss, even if you're 10 minutes late from school, best believe an automatic message has already been sent to your parents. Whereas at university, they don't do that. Like, if you don't turn up for college, if you don't turn up for university, they're not going to be calling your mum and dad asking where you are. Like, if you don't read your chapter book, they're not going to be arranging a detention and you've got 10 minutes of detention after school. That isn't going to happen. So I think the differences between that may be why some people feel that nursing school wants them to fail. That's because you are in the driver's seat of your learning. You have to push for your learning. So there is support out there. You know, some universities obviously will not be as great as other universities. I'm not even going to sit here and lie to you. However, there is support there. There are things that you can do that you can put in place to, you know, kind of reduce the likelihood of you failing out of the course for whatever reason. But the myth that nursing school wants you to fail, no, that isn't true. I think that may also come from the nature of the nursing degree, because I'm not even gonna lie, the workload of the nursing degree is hard. You've got 2-3 essays due in, you've got to go to placement, you've got to meet competencies of placement. The workload can be a lot. And there were times when I felt like a donkey. I felt like I was being beaten like a donkey and being told you have to do this. And I'm thinking, I've got the time. Like, how am I supposed to do this? But you know, thousands of people, I want to say hundreds of thousands, but I don't think we have that many student nurses, but thousands of student nurses graduate every year and they make the transition from student nurse to adult nurse. So best believe if they can do it, I'm 100% sure that you can do it. The third myth is that in nursing school, you have to compete. Like all of the points, these points will be based off my experience, and I didn't find nursing school competitive. I don't want to say that I didn't find it competitive at all, but I do want to say that I didn't find nursing school any more or any less competitive than I found GCSE or A-level. Let's be real. Wherever you go, where you find a whole bunch of students taking exams, taking assessments on a regular basis, there will always be like an element of competition. Like, oh my gosh, what did you get? Oh my gosh, what did you get? And in your mind, you're thinking, oh, I could have done better. There's always going to be an element of competition. But best believe the course isn't set up that way. The course isn't designed to put mental health students against adult nurses. It isn't designed to put first years against second years. It isn't designed to put this learning group against this learning group. It's, in a sense, it's actually the opposite. They want people to work together. They want people to work they want people to collaborate with each other, because that is what you're going to do, or that is what you're going to have to do when you become a registered nurse. Working as a nurse, think about it, it's not a competitive profession. I'm not competing against the nurse in the next bay. I'm not competing against the nurse in the next ward. No, we're all working together for the good of our patients. And that is what you'll see during your nursing degree. Like I said, you know, wherever you find students taking exams and presentations and assessments, there will be a degree of competitiveness. But I really do think that that is down to human nature. I don't want to say that I'm a competitive person. I don't think I am, but I'm always competing against my previous self. Let's just say I got 70% in this reflective essay. Okay, I got 70%. My next reflective essay, I want to get 75%. If I got, you know, 80% in this analytical essay, my next essay, I want to get 90%. If I got 90%, the next essay, I want to get 93%. So really, your biggest competition should be yourself and not people that you're working with or people on your cohort, because everyone's different. People have different learning styles. Some people are good at presentations, or some people are better at presenting than they are at writing essays. Some people are better at coursework than they are at doing exams. Everyone is different. So yes, it's good to look at other people's grades and, you know, use them as examples for yourself and use it as motivation and inspiration. I know that on my course, if there was someone that I knew got a really, really good grade, like 90%, 93%, even 97% and up, if it was someone that I knew, I'd be like, hey, I know I passed my essay, but I know you did really, really well. Can I just look at your essay and kind of just see what you did? And then I'll just kind of take like some tips based off their essay and then apply that to my next essay. Not that I'm thinking, oh, I got 80%. Oh, she got 86%. Oh, I'm going to be hella jealous. I'm going to be making noise every time she's got an essay to write. Like, don't do that. Because I'm laughing now, because there are people who do that. There are actually people who do that. Don't do that. Your biggest competition should be yourself. And no, nursing school isn't like competitive, because the course is designed that way. It's just down to human nature. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, this video is in partnership with www.nursingpersonalstatement.co.uk. It is such a fantastic website, so many resources. If you want me to have a look at your essays or your personal statements before you submit them, then make sure you head over to that website. Similarly, if you're really into blogs and you like reading content rather than watching content, then you can also make sure you head over to that website. The fourth and final myth that I want to kind of dispel in this video is that first year doesn't count. Like, that is an actual lie. Like, that's not even a myth, but that's actually a lie. But when I googled nursing school myths, this is, you know, it didn't really come up, but it's one thing that I had in my head that I know a lot of student nurses at the time when I was a student, and some student nurses who are out there now, thought was a natural thing. They think, oh, first year doesn't count. First year does count. And I think where this myth has come from is that at my university, and I think the majority of universities, the grades that you get for first year do not contribute to the overall weighting of your final degree classification. But it doesn't mean it does not count. If you don't pass first year, that's it for it, you're done at it. And some people understand that it counts in the sense that you need to pass first year in order to progress, but even though they understand that you need to pass first year, they understand that it doesn't count towards the overall degree classification. So they're thinking, oh, in first year, I'm just gonna pass, I'm just gonna be scraping my 40%, my 50%, whatever the boundary is or the benchmark is at your university. They're thinking, I'm just gonna scrape past, I'm just gonna scrape by, I'm not gonna push myself too hard, I'm just gonna do whatever I want to do. And if I get a 41%, as long as I pass, I don't care. And then when it comes to second and third year, when, you know, my grades do count towards my degree classification, then I'm gonna push myself and then I'm gonna work hard, I'm gonna work harder. Yes, in theory, that makes sense. You know, relax in first year and then work hard in second and third year. But working hard isn't something that just occurs overnight. You can't be like, I'm not saying, because some people just about scrape first year and they do put a lot of effort in. I'm not talking about those students. I'm talking about students who can put in more effort, but because they're thinking first year doesn't apply, they're just fine with getting 40%, 40%, and then, you know, they think second year and third year, I'm gonna work harder. It's not a thing, like I said, it's not a thing that just occurs overnight. Working harder isn't just a thing that just, you know, at the click of a finger you can do. If it was that easy, then why aren't you working really hard? Why aren't you putting all the effort that you can do? When people say, oh, I'm gonna work harder in second and third year, what does working harder mean? What does working harder mean? If you really deep it, working harder doesn't just mean spending, like, you know, 2 hours at the library rather than 10 minutes at the library. Working harder doesn't mean, well, for me anyway, working harder doesn't mean waking up at 6 o'clock in the morning instead of 10 o'clock in the morning. There are principles that you have to apply in terms of, okay, I'm writing a reflective essay. This is how I do a reflective essay. Okay, I'm doing a presentation. These are the general principles of doing these are the general principles on how to present, you know, this case study or whatever. If it's not something that you've practiced in first year, how do you think that you're just gonna learn all of those skills in second and third year? No, you should start learning those skills in first year, and then obviously as you progress throughout your degree, you refine. Not that you just kind of pass everything on a whim, and then you think you're just gonna start working harder. Like, waking up an hour earlier doesn't mean you're working harder. You've literally just woken up an hour earlier if you're gonna wake up and do the exact same thing that you would have done if you woke up, you know, at 12 in the afternoon. Start from first year. And even if you look at the levels of motivation in terms of the amount of enthusiasm and motivation you have in the first year of your degree in comparison to the amount of motivation that you don't have in the, you know, the final 6 months, the final 3 months of your degree, some people would argue that it's actually easier to get higher grades in first year than it is to get higher grades in your second and third year. So that's it, that is the end of this video. I have shared 4 nursing school myths. If you would like more videos like this, then make sure you give this video a like. If you want to see more videos from me, then make sure you subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.